It is now day 3 of Iceland's latest eruption of the Reykjanes volcano, and the top news is that a slowly advancing lava flow has now completely covered the main parking lot of the Blue Lagoon. Yes, the same parking lot that hundreds of thousands of tourists use each year. Thankfully, the Blue Lagoon proper is still undamaged as the dirt and rock berms continue to successfully hold, with hard-working construction crews actively filling in any gaps which existed beforehand. This lava flow made a slight detour to the west along a portion of Iceland Road 426, which it is actively advancing along due to being blocked by a slightly higher patch of ground that bounds what was a parking lot to its direct south. However, while that lava lobe's advance has slowed to a crawl, a secondary lobe of the north made a minor breakout, advancing 800 meters north of the February 2024 lava field. Due to this motion, the lava field has now expanded from 7.43 to 7.67 square kilometers in size. Here is where that figure ranks among the 6 prior eruptions since December of 2023 from the same volcano. While the sheer distance this lava flow has traveled might make the eruption seem larger than it is, there is a legitimate reason why lava traveled much further west than beforehand. Simply put, lava flows largely flow downhill towards areas of lower terrain. The last two eruptions beforehand emplaced very thick fields of lava to the south in May and east and north in August, thus redirecting the majority of lava towards one direction, the west. More recent analysis has once again reinforced an earlier suggestion I made that only around 32 million cubic meters of lava could be involved in the entirety of this eruption based on the amount of magma that transferred from the 5-kilometer depth magma chamber towards the erupting fissure to the east. However, as you can see in this tremor chart, eruptive activity has notably declined during the last 48 hours. You can ignore the blue band as that is contaminated by noise from variations in wind and wave height in the Atlantic Ocean. So, why is less lava expected to and has been erupting than their prior eruptions from May and August? I am considering 3 possibilities. Possibility 1 is that while the prior 4 eruptions had followed a nice slightly exponential trend, it appears that the system finally reached a threshold that cannot accommodate any more magma input before causing a magma run event. This amount of magma input at shallow depths underground correlates quite well at the Reykjanes volcano to the amount of ground uplift which is observed. In this case, that figure equates to somewhere between 28 and 32 centimeters or 11 to 12.6 inches. If true, it suggests that we may have reached a temporary upper bound for the volume of magma which can erupt as long as the Reykjanes volcano stays highly active, with a figure of 65 million to 70 million cubic meters. Possibilities 2 and 3 suggest that the ongoing eruption sort of occurred accidentally. You see, on March 2nd this year, a failed magmatic intrusion occurred with very minimal earthquakes. I suggest the possibility that a similar event occurred on November 20th, but because it was ever so slightly larger in magnitude that it ended up producing an eruption. The third possibility is that what I just described happened, but that some of the magma it encountered in what ended up partially erupting included material from that failed March 2nd intrusion. But these are just my unproven ideas. For a quick reference, here is the current hazard map overlaid on the ongoing eruption, which is accurate until 3 p.m. local time in Iceland on November 22nd. While the first 3 hours of the eruption saw 2,605 meters long of fissure erupt, today this figure has declined all the way to 544 meters or 20.9% of its original length. This has divided into 3 active fissure segments, the largest of which happens to be in the middle, and that is likely where the dominant spatter cone will eventually develop. As a final note, I would like to thank my new patron Richard Lennon for supporting this channel.